what is actually we are doing in contour integration there. All these things you should do a little bit. If you understand, or you'll understand, right? Evaluation of real definite integrals by contour integration. That was a definite, I mean, heading she gave, right? Evaluation of real, 1 minute, I'll just explain a little bit and then move on to the other thing. Evaluation of real definite integrals by the contour integration. Why we are doing this? See, this real definite integrals of the form, suppose you have integral 0 to 2 pi f of cos theta comma sin theta, you would have seen, but that was a type 1. So integrals of the form, integral 0 to 2 pi f of cos theta comma sin theta into d theta. This was the first form we had. So when you are not able to integrate in the real plane, we try to change the integration in some other plane and we integrate it. So few of the real integrals, we can even integrate in that, and you can even use contour integration and you are going to do the integration. When we are changing into contour integration, what is that contour integration? Contour integration, nothing but using the complexity, okay, complex plane. We are changing from the real plane to the complex plane. When we are changing from the real plane to the complex plane, we are, what we are doing is we are taking the variable z and we are substituting into e power I theta. When we are substituting e power I theta, you know that what is the r value here? 1. So it is on the unit circle. So that's why the integration is changing to the unit circle there. Okay. So your integration is changing to an unit circle. So because your substitution is z is equals to e power I theta, you know that generally when you are substituting the polar coordinates, e power I theta means what is that? R is your radius. Distance here it is 1. So when you are converting this, you are substituting dz equal to e power I theta, and what is your substitution for dz? Ma, d theta by, what's the substitution for d theta is equals to dz by iz. You would have substituted it, okay? So d theta equal to dz by iz. And what is the substitution for cos theta? Cos theta is 1 by 2 into z plus 1 by z, or you would have written as z square plus 1 by 2z. Both are okay. And similarly, sine theta is equals to 1 by 2 into z minus 1 by z. This is the substitution you would have done. When you are doing this substitution, when you are changing the given function, that real function, whenever the real function, when you are changing it to a complex plane, so when you are converting it, it is converting to an unit circle. Okay, it is converting to an unit circle. So type 1, you would have seen the integrals of the form 0 to 2 pi f of cos theta comma sin theta d theta. And similarly, in the type 2, what is what you have seen in a type 2, integrals of the form integral over minus infinity to infinity. What did you see? Minus infinity to infinity?
f of x
into? Come on, tell me. Yesterday only you did, right? F of x into cos. What? Yeah, no one is saying anything. You have taken notes, right?
Ma'am, type 2 was f of x dx.
It was of the form integral over infinity. Some rational function here. Instead of f of x, you would have some p of x by q of x. Yes or no? This is the function would have given into dx. So this was your type 2. Whenever you have this integration, what did she say? What did the teacher say? How will you integrate it? How the region is being taken? That is very important. Tell me.
I'm first have to define a semicircle, like there will be two integrations inside that. One integration will go from minus r to r, and the second integration will be like around the semicircle.
This entire, this quantity, you will take it as some pi of z. Simply you will replace x by z, right? Simply you'll replace x by z, but the integration will be taken along over the semicircle. Okay. The integration will be taken along the semicircle bounded by the line segment minus r to r. Okay. Minus r to r. This semicircle, what name she gave? She gave gamma or C1?
I'm C1.
C1. Okay. Then I'll make it a C1 itself, because you should not have confusion. So your original integral over minus infinity to infinity pi of z dz will convert from this line segment minus R to R and the semicircle C1 and the semicircle C1. That is the way you would have done the integration, yes or no? So you would have taken minus R to R pi of x dx. Why I'm taking from minus R to R pi of x? This is a real line. All the values will be in terms of x. So I'm taking this pi of x dx plus integral over C1 f of pi of z dz. Pi of z dz. After that, when you evaluate it, you will put R tends to infinity. When you are making it R tends to infinity, you are dragging this. Your line segment, you are dragging it. What will happen to the semicircle when you drag this?
That will collapse,
ma'am. Zero. The semicircle will become almost, when expanding it, it's going to become almost a straight line. It's going to become a straight line. So that's why this integral minus infinity to infinity pi of x dx will exist and this will become zero. There will be no semicircle. It will be only a straight line there. So this will become zero. So using that concept, we find the integration value of this. That is the way it would have been done. So you would have understood both the things, right? And for everything, we would have used Cauchy residue theorem. Yes or no? We would have used Cauchy residue theorem to evaluate the integrals. You know that the Cauchy residue theorem is what? Whatever the integral is given, it is 2 pi a into sum of the residues. Okay. 2 pi a into sum of the residues. So if you have clearly understood the type 1 and type 2, I'm moving on to the type 3. Is it clear? So you don't have any doubts in type 1 and type 2, right? And tomorrow you should not tell me that, ma'am, we didn't understand. Later on, this word should not be there. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am, understood.
Very good. Then fine. I'm happy about it. Okay. So we'll move on to the type 3. So type 3 is similar to the type 2. Okay. Type 3 is similar to the type 2. Only the difference is there you'll have a rational function. Here you'll have a particular form. Okay. So you'll have a type 3. So type 3 will be of the form integral over minus infinity to infinity f of x into cos mx dx, or it will be of the form integral over minus infinity to infinity f of x sin mx dx. So if you have some function with sin mx or cos mx, you are going to evaluate it. Oh, where how the functions will be is the f of x will be tending to zero as x tends to infinity. This is the way the functions would have been given. So what we are going to do is to evaluate this integral, same thing we are going to do. Only the difference what we are going to take is you have cos mx and sin mx. What do you know about e power I mx? Can anyone tell me what is e power I mx? What is e power I theta? Cos mx plus I sin mx. Very good. So suppose we want real part of this. Suppose we want real part of x. What it will be?
Cos mx.
Only cos mx. We want imaginary part. It's going to be sin mx. So whenever you have the form of cos mx, okay, we will express this integral as real part of f of x or whatever it is. And similarly, whenever you have sin mx, we are going to express it as imaginary part of f of x. And the evaluation procedure, everything is similar to the type 2. Here also, we are going to take a semicircle bounded by the line segment minus r to r with the radius small r. Okay, with the radius small r. So that is the way we are going to take the semicircle and we are going to do the same steps, whatever we have done in the type 2. And we are going to evaluate it. Okay, so I'll directly move on to the problems. You can just take down this type 3, the integrals of the form minus infinity to infinity f of x is equals to cos mx dx or f of x is equals to sin mx dx, where f of x tends to 0 as x tends to infinity. Okay, take down, evaluate. Evaluate integral over 0 to infinity cos ax divided by 1 plus x square into dx divided by 1 plus x square into dx. Evaluate integral over 0 to infinity cos ax divided by 1 plus x square into dx, where a is greater than 0. Where a is greater than 0. So this is your given integral. What I'll do is I will rewrite this given integral in the form integral over 0 to infinity cos ax divided by 1 plus x square into dx can be written as 1 by 2 into integral over minus infinity to infinity cos ax divided by 1 plus x square into dx. Yes or no?
Yes.
How I'm writing this? What is cos? Cos is also an even function. Even function or of not cos?
Yes, ma'am. Cos is an even.
Cos is even function, and the denominator here it is also an even function. This entire thing is even function. So I can express integral over minus infinity to infinity cos ax divided by 1 plus x square into dx as 2 times of 0 to infinity. So I'm writing it as 1 by 2 into integral over minus infinity to infinity cos ax by 1 plus x square. Still further, what I can do is I can write this as 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 into real part of 1 by 2 into real part of e power iax. See, I'm writing this cos ax as real part of e power iax integral over minus infinity to infinity divided by 1 plus x square into dx. Is it clear? I'm writing it as yes. 1 by 2 into real part of e power iax divided by 1 plus x square into dx. Now just see what is this form. This integral alone. You can see it is of the form integral over minus infinity to infinity some p of x by q of x into dx. Now it is of the type 2. Okay, we are going to use the type 2 and we are going to come back to this. So I'll take this as equation number 1. I'll take this integral alone and evaluate it. Okay, so I'll take now integral over minus infinity to infinity, e power iax divided by 1 plus x square, e power iax divided by 1 plus x square into dx. Whenever you have this integral, what you will do, you will do the substitution simply x is equals to z. So what will happen, when you substitute it in terms of z, however we are converting this integral, we are converting this given integral in the form of unit circle. Semicircle. Okay, you can just write down. So this is equals to integral over c e power iaz divided by 1 plus z square into dz, where c is the semicircle bounded by the line segment minus r to r and the semicircle c1 and the semicircle c1. Is it clear? Is it clear or not? Yes. Okay. Now, how can I rewrite this? I can rewrite this as integral over c dz divided by, e power iaz into dz. E power iaz into dz divided by 1 plus z square. Okay. 1 plus z square will be equal to integral over, minus r to r, integral over minus r to r, pi of x dx plus integral over c1 into pi of z dz. Okay. Now, what is your pi of x? I can shall I write it directly. Your pi of x is nothing but e power iax dx divided by 1 plus x square. And similarly, your pi of z is nothing but, your pi of z is nothing but e power iaz dz divided by 1 plus z square. 1 plus z square. Now, what is our aim? Our aim is to evaluate the given integral. So, when you are going to evaluate this integral, you are going to use Cauchy residue theorem. So, using the Cauchy residue theorem, we are going to evaluate this. So, what does the Cauchy residue theorem says? Here, what is your pi of z, ma? Pi of z is e power iaz divided by 1 plus z square. Retain this. Now, we will find the poles. What are the poles here? Z is equals to z square plus 1 is equals to 0. So what z square equal to minus 1? What will be z? Z is equals to plus or minus I. Z is equals to plus or minus I are the poles of order
1.
Z is equals to plus or minus I are the poles of order 1. So here which pole will lie inside and which pole will lie outside, ma?
Ma'am, plus I will lie inside, minus I will lie outside.
Because your region is only this. Minus r to r, this is your region. So only plus I will lie inside, minus I will lie outside. So here z is equals to I lies inside the given region C. inside the given region C, and Z is equals to minus I lies outside. So what you should find, we should find the residue. We should find the residue of pi of Z at Z is equals to I. So what it is, it is a pole of order one. So limit Z tends to I, Z minus I into f of Z. What is into pi of Z? What is your pi of Z? E power I a Z divided by 1 plus Z square. So I can write it as Z plus I into Z minus I. So Z minus I will be getting cancelled. Okay. And substitute this I, you will get e power minus a. See, I into I will become I square minus 1 you will get. So I square divided by 2i divided by 2i. This is your residue of the function pi of Z at Z is equals to I. Now what we want integral over C, whatever the integration. What is your pi of Z? E power I a Z dz divided by 1 plus z square in 1 plus z square is equals to 2 pi I into sum of the residues at its poles, which is equals to 2 pi I into what is your sum of the residues? It is e power minus a, okay, e power minus a divided by 2i. So 2 and I will be getting cancelled. So you will get pi e power minus a. You will get pi e power minus a. Substitute this in 2. Substitute this in 2. This you can take it as equation number 2. This you can take it as equation number 2. When you substitute this in 2, okay, 2 implies, see, this integral, right? This integral value only we have found out. What is the value of this integral? This integral value only we have found out to be pi into e power minus a. So pi into e power minus a is equals to integral over minus r to r, okay, minus r to r pi of x dx, which is equals to e power I a x by 1 plus x square into dx plus integral over c1 e power iaz divided by 1 plus z square into dx. Okay, what is this actually? I forgot to say this. What type of lemma is this, ma? Did she say that?
Yes, ma'am, she mentioned, but can't remember.
What type of lemma it is? She would have said the lemma, right? You don't remember the lemma.
She just said that as r tends to infinity, the second integral becomes zero.
Yeah, second integral becomes zero because you are stretching it. But the name of the lemma is also there, right?
Yes, ma'am, I can't remember that.
1 minute, wait. I also forgot the lemma name. I'll just check it with the thing and tell you. Okay, anyways. Jordan lemma, yeah. That the lemma is called as Jordan lemma. By Jordan lemma only we have this, okay? So by using that, we are stretching r tends to infinity, okay? We are stretching r tends to infinity. When you stretch r tends to infinity, your left hand side is pi into e power minus a. This will become integral over minus infinity to infinity. E power I a x divided by 1 plus x square into dx. This will become zero. Now what we got? We got the value of integral over minus infinity to infinity e power I a x divided by 1 plus x square into dx as pi e power minus a. Substitute this in 1. Okay, substitute this in 1. So what is your equation number 1, ma? Equation number 1. Integral 0 to infinity cos ax by 1 plus x square into dx is equals to 1 by 2i into real part of this. Okay, so directly I'll substitute it. So when I substitute this in 1, so 1 implies what is in the left hand side? Integral over 0 to infinity e power iax, right?
Yes, ma'am.
No. It is integral 0 to infinity cos ax by 1 plus x square. Cos ax by 1 plus x square into dx is equals to 1 by 2 into, what did I write? 1 by 2 into real part of. 1 by 2 into real part of this integration value, we got it, is equals to pi e power minus a. There is no imaginary part in this answer. So everything is real part. You have to take it directly. So this is equals to pi by 2 into e power minus a. This is your answer. So this is your given integral. Integral over 0 to infinity cos ax divided by 1 plus x square into dx. You all understood? Cos ax divided by 1 plus this one into this one. The answer is pi e power a, sorry, pi e power minus a by 2. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Anyone has any doubts? In that case, we'll do one more problem. Just check whether you have done this problem. Prove that integral over minus infinity to infinity dx divided by x square plus 1 the whole cube is equals to 3 pi by 8. Have you done this? Okay, now tell me what type is this. I will give you now mixed problems, because you know type 1, type 2 and type 3. So I'm giving you mixed problems. You have to identify the type and then start doing the problem. So it is of the form integral over minus infinity to infinity dx divided by x square plus 1 the whole cube. There is no cos mx or sin mx along with this. So what is this?
Type 2, ma'am.
Yes, for your reference, I'm writing it. This is of type 2. Okay, whenever you have type 2, what you have to do, dear? What you should do?
X is equal to
z. Simply have to replace x by z. So integral over minus infinity to infinity dz divided by z square plus 1 the whole cube you are going to take. Where? What is your pi of z? Pi of z is nothing but 1 by z square plus 1 the whole cube. Z square plus 1 the whole cube. Okay. Oh, sorry, ma. I made one mistake. I just wanted to write this and write it. Integral over minus infinity to infinity dx divided by x first plus 1 the whole cube. This I am replacing it as integral over c. Minus infinity to infinity will change it to integral over c. dz divided by z square plus 1 the whole cube. Where, what is your c? Write down. C is the semicircle C1 and the line segment minus R to R, please write down, and the line segment minus R to R. C is the semicircle bounded by the line segment with the line segment minus R to R. So by Cauchy residue theorem, you are going to evaluate this. So by Cauchy residue theorem, you can write integral over C dz divided by z square plus 1 the whole cube. Z square plus 1 the whole cube is equals to integral over minus R to R dx divided by x square plus 1 the whole cube plus integral over C1 dz divided by z square plus 1 the whole cube. Okay, take this as equation number 1. Now we are going to evaluate this. So integral over C dz divided by z square plus 1 the whole cube, we are going to evaluate using Cauchy residue theorem. Okay, here Cauchy residue theorem, we are going to evaluate it. So I'll write it here like that. So here, pi of z is equals to dz divided by z square plus 1 the whole cube. Here, z is equals to, what are the poles, ma? Here, z is equals to plus or minus I are poles of?
Order 3.
Very good. Poles of order 3. Okay. So we are going to check which are the poles lying inside first. So here, z is equals to I lies inside C, and z is equals to minus I lies outside C. Okay. Minus outside C. So therefore, we are going to find residue of the function pi of z at z is equals to I. So what is that? It is a pole of order 2. So 1 by 2 factorial into d square by, sorry. It's a pole of order 2, right? So it will become d by dz of, right? Pole of order 3 or yes. Order 2, ma? Order 3. Order 3 means d square by dz square. Okay. D square by dz square. Limit, I can write it here. Limit z tends to I. Limit z tends to I. So 1 by 2 factorial into limit z tends to I d square by dz square into z minus I the whole cube into pi of z. What is your pi of z? Pi of z is nothing but 1 by 1 by z minus I the whole cube into z plus I the whole cube. 1 by z minus I the whole cube into z plus I the whole cube. So z minus I the whole cube and this will be getting cancelled. Now you have to differentiate this. So 1 by 2 factor will become 1 by 2. So I'll write it as 2. So limit z tends to I you have z tends to I d by dz of, when you integrate this, you'll get minus 3 into z plus I whole power minus 4. Whole power minus 4, one time if you differentiate. Second time when you differentiate this, you'll get 1 by 2 limit z tends to I. This is 1 by 2 limit z tends to I. One more time if you integrate it, you'll get 12 into, okay? 12 into z minus z plus I. Z plus I whole power minus 5. So I can write this as 1 by 2 into limit z tends to I. 12 divided by z plus I whole power 5. 12 divided by z plus I whole power 5. Okay. Now simplify this. Get 1 by 2 into limit. I'll substitute the limit. When I substitute the limit, I'll get 12 divided by I plus I is 2i. 2i into whole power 5. So this will become 1 by 2 into 12 by 2 power 5. What is I power 5, ma? I square will get minus 1, minus 1. This will become plus 1 into I you will get. You understood? So you'll get into I. Now simplify this. Simplify this. 2, 6 are 12. So 1, 2, if you cancel it, you will get 3. Okay, 3. So you'll get 2 power 4. What is 2 power 4?
16, ma'am.
16. So this will be equal to 3 by 16 I. So, okay, 3 by 16 I. So is your residue. Okay, 3 by 16 I is your residue. Now what we want actually integral over your given function. What is your given function? It is dz divided by z square plus 1 the whole cube into dz is equals to 2 pi I by Cauchy residue theorem. This is 2 pi I into sum of the residues. Sum of the residues is 3 by 16 I. So I and I will be getting cancelled. 2 and this will be getting cancelled. You will get 3 by 8. Only 3 by 8. So I is getting cancelled and this is getting cancelled. So you'll get 3 by 8. Okay. Now what we want, sorry, pi is there, Nama. 3 pi by 8. Okay. This you can substitute in equation number 1. So 1 implies 3 pi by 8 is equals to integral over minus r to r. Integral over minus r to r. What is your pi of x? Which is dx divided by x square plus 1 the whole cube plus integral over c1. dz divided by z square plus 1 the whole cube into dz. Now, again, letting r tends to infinity, what will have? This implies integral over minus infinity to infinity dx divided by x square plus 1 the whole cube. X square plus 1 the whole cube is equals to, this will become 0. C1 will become 0 is equals to 3 pi by 8. This only we want, right? Square plus 1 the whole cube, which is equals to 3 pi by 8. Anyone has any doubts, ma, in this problem? Please write it clearly. Whenever you write type 2, you have to write this. This equation, if you don't write, I will not give you marks. Otherwise, it is meaningless. You should write what is C also. Here itself, I wrote it. Where C is a semicircle bounded by this and this. Therefore, by Cauchy residue theorem, we are going to evaluate it. So using this, this is of the form. After that only, you should do. Otherwise, surely I will not give you marks. Okay, so next one, you're going to evaluate it again. Evaluate, just check whether you've done this problem. Evaluate integral over 0 to infinity. Integral over 0 to infinity x sin x. 0 to infinity x sin x divided by, sorry, x square plus a square. Evaluate integral over 0 to infinity x sin x divided by x square plus a square into dx. X square plus a square into dx. Come on, evaluate this. What is of this form, ma?
From type 3 now.
Type 3 is from minus infinity to infinity. So you should rewrite this given integral first. So when you rewrite this, you have to write it as integral over 0 to infinity x sin x divided by x square plus a square. X square plus a square. How are we writing it? X is an odd function. This is an odd function. Odd into odd, this will become even. So even by even, it will be even function. Then only you can write this. Otherwise, you cannot write it. You can write it as 1 by 2 into integral over minus infinity to infinity x sin x divided by x square plus a square into dx. Now this is of the form type 3. Okay. So whenever you have type 3, you can write it as, if you want to just write it for your reference, this is of the form type 3. So whenever you have type 3, you can simply write this as integral over c z sin z. No, you cannot write z sin z. So sin z, you can write it as real part of, real part or imaginary part? Imaginary part of e power I z. Imaginary part of e power I z divided by z square plus a square into dz. What is c? Immediately you write down. Where c is the semicircle bounded by the line, semicircle c1 bounded by the line segment minus r to r. Okay. Now, so therefore, your integral over where c is the semicircle bounded by this and this. Okay. Then you can directly write down. So this is equals to 1 by 2 into integral over c. Integral over c, you can take the imaginary part outside. You can write it as z e power I z divided by z square plus a square. Z square plus a square into dz. You can write it as z e power I z divided by z square plus a square into dz. Okay. Now we are going to evaluate this. So to evaluate this, take this as equation number 1. So you are going to rewrite this given equation z e power I z divided by z square plus a square into dz in the form of this semicircle c, which is given by integral over minus r to r pi of x dx. So this will become e power I x divided by x square plus a square into dx plus integral over c1, which is z e power I z divided by z square plus a square into dz. Now take this as equation number 2. Now we are going to evaluate using Cauchy residue theorem. What is here pi of z, ma? Here pi of z is equals to z e power I z divided by z square plus a square. Z square plus a square. Now here z is equals to plus or minus I a are poles of order 1. So here z is equals to I a lies inside C and Z is equals to minus IA lies outside C. Okay, only positive axis, positive imaginary axis only will lie inside. Okay, so minus IA lie outside. So therefore, you have to find the residue. You have to find the residue of the function pi of Z at Z is equals to AI, which is a pole of order 1. So therefore, limit Z tends to AI, Z minus AI into pi of z. What is your pi of z? Z e power I z divided by z plus I a into z minus I a. So z minus I a will be getting cancelled. So this, when you substitute AI, you will get AI into e power I into I a divided by I a into I a will become 2 I a. Okay, what will happen here? Your I and A will be getting cancelled. So this will become e power minus a by 2. This will become e power minus a by 2. Anyone has any doubts till here? Okay. So by Cauchy residue theorem, integral over, okay, integral over, what is your integral, ma? Integral over c. Integral over c, z e power I z divided by z square plus a square into dz is equals to 2 pi I into sum of the residues at its poles, which will be equal to 2 pi I into, what is your residue here? E power minus a divided by 2. So 2 and 2 will be getting cancelled. You'll get I into pi e power minus a. Substitute this in equation number 2. So what is your 2? 2 will be, the left hand side value is I into pi e power minus a. This will be equal to integral over minus x to, sorry. 2 implies, this is integral over minus infinity to infinity. So not infinity to infinity. Integral over minus r to r, your pi of x. What is your pi of x? X sine x divided by x square plus a square into dx plus integral over minus infinity, sorry, integral over c1. Integral over c1, z sine z divided by z square plus a square into dz. This only I wrote number in the 2.
Yes, ma'am.
No, I wrote it in terms of e power I a z. Imaginary part, you will get confused, no, if I substitute 2 and write it like that.
Okay, ma'am. Can write
it. Because whatever I write there is important. Same way I should write here, right? Today it will look okay, but tomorrow you'll have confusion. E power I z into dz. Okay. So r is tending to infinity. So we'll get I into pi e power minus a will be equal to integral over minus infinity to infinity x e power I x divided by x square plus a square into dx plus 0. Substitute this in equation number 1. So what is your 1? Your 1 is integral over 0 to infinity x sine x divided by x square plus a square into dx is equals to 1 by 2 into imaginary part of whatever the answer you have. It is I into pi e power minus a. What is the imaginary part, ma? Only this. So you'll get pi by 2 into e power minus a. A. Pi by 2 into e power minus a. Understood? See, steps are important. You should correlate and come back to the same step. Simply solving, it will surely reduce marks. Again, I am telling you, if you simply roughly solve, I will not agree. You have to come back to the proper form, then only I'll give you the marks. Solving is simple only. You take. Other things we'll see in the next class. And today I'll be uploading your DA also. So start doing the DA, because I think deadline have given us 23rd something. So today I'll upload it. Okay. And quiz 2, you're going to write it after CAT 2. Is it clear?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. We'll wind up the class here. Other things we'll see in the next class.